Monsignor, thank you for coming.
Oh, it's my pleasure. I consider it a privilege to perform last rites.
Well, thank God you're a man of compassion. We called several priests in the area, but they were all in a panic over the news reports. Especially after they published those grim pictures of her.
What exactly is wrong with her?
No one knows. Our doctors have ordered a battery of tests. But she did test positive for TB.
Oh, I didn't realize there were still new cases.
I should warn you. The sight of her is quite shocking.
We're all God's creatures.
I'll be in the hall if you need me.
Afraid of some old campfire story? I'm a grown-ass man.
Need help?
You run this place?
41 years now, but you're in the wrong place. We're closed for the season.
Do you recognize these people? Val Butler and Jason Bennett. They stayed here back in 2008.
Long time ago, 2008. Seen a lot of faces come and go.
They would have been here in November. Do you remember anything unusual from that period?
You wouldn't happen to know their room numbers?
213 and 313.
The 13s. Those rooms, they're not normal rooms. They're reserved for people involved in trials at the courthouse. Down at 1135 Elm.
The murders have to be connected to a trial held at the courthouse in November of 08.
There's only one trial. Took place in November 08. It's a terrible thing.
You remember a trial from 5 years ago?
No one here can forget. It was the trial of the century. That man murdered half a dozen people.
Who are you talking about?
Nigel Molloy.
Guys, I gotta be honest with you. I've just gotten a great offer from another developer.
What are they planning on doing with that?
Pretty much rip everything out and put in office space.
That's a terrible idea. You can't let them do that.
Excuse me.
Well, he didn't mean it like that.
I do have another meeting to get to, gentlemen.
Okay, you know, I'll make this really quick. You own a historical treasure.
People in real estate don't like to hear the word historical.
Okay.
It is very romantic and appealing, but this other developer has a really solid long-term plan, and I gotta be smart here, guys.
Well, I think this is the smart financial thing. We're not leaving. We're here to lease this space and make our business work.
Just a better stripper pole.
She slipped. Make sure she's all right.
Off a pole?
It was our anniversary. They installed it right in the bedroom.
I wanted it to be a surprise.
It was. I was getting an iPad.
Why don't you get Mr. Olson's past medical history while I order a scan?
See that? Your face. Now imagine how I felt.
Your wife is horny. Leonard, she wants some sex. She needs it.
Oh.
Is the equipment working, sir?
Yes.
Good. Then use it. Just do it.
If I could just collect some general information on the deceased, social security number, certificate of birth.
Yeah, I have none of that crap. Just dig the hole.
We're just looking for a simple but dignified burial.
And how many will we be expecting at the service?
Counting him, one.
What do we do first?
The selection of a casket. We offer a nice variety, beginning with the Truman, 20-gauge steel with a crepe interior. It's very basic, not something I typically recommend. I might suggest the Promethean blue velvet, very popular in Cincinnati, dignified, understated, and in my mind, quite timeless.
How much?
$32,800.
We'll take the hefty. You're going to Jewish hell too, by the way. What a crook.
Well, it's good to see you. We hadn't heard from him in a while. Thought maybe he'd forgotten you by now.
Someone could have been hurt.
I'm happy to see that you're better. Very happy.
Thank you for everything.
Better take him into the other room. I suspect he's seen enough for one day.
See you, Julian.